Hello and welcome for round number 12, the final round of the Apex Racing Academy Formula 3 Championship. It's the season finale from Autodromo Nazionale di Monza, a great public park in the heart of the Italian town. Alongside me is Marco Barbanera. I'm Alessandro, and Marco today has double duty because he will be joining me in the commentary and also dealing with the production as usual. Marco, are you ready for some extraordinary racing here, Draft Fest guaranteed at Monza?
Hello Alessandro, absolutely, not only I'm ready for what's going to be, you know, Monza always provides for some fantastic racing, especially in these open wheel cars with a lot of drafting capabilities, but of course it's a season finale, the title still to be decided between two absolutely fantastic competitors. And so we really don't know which way this is going to end. Here is the standings, and as you can see, it's Pagotto versus Albon. Holland is close, but not close enough. He cannot win the title. Mathematically, he is out of the running. What are the permutations, you might ask? Well, we shall give them to you. If Albon wins the race, Pagotto must finish fourth or higher to win the title. If Albon finishes second, Pagotto must finish ninth or higher. If Albon finishes third, Pagotto must finish 13th or higher. If Albon finishes fourth position or worse than fourth, there is no way he can overtake Pagotto. There are no drop scores, nothing. We will keep you posted, of course, during the event, Alessandro, and we'll give reminders to the drivers. But of course, Monza, the first obstacle these drivers will have to face, title contenders or not, is the first lap, the first two chicanes. They can be quite deadly.
Oh yeah, for sure. I've been seeing some clips of this combination this week around the internet, and definitely we've seen the usual troubles in the opening laps, but for the time being Luca Albon putting himself in a very good position. He's at the moment our pole sitter with 143.224, Pagotto only 6, but obviously it's the second lap that counts in this car when tires start to come up temperature and the drivers can put their fastest lap in. So it's gonna be very, very important for these two drivers, especially to get a very good starting position to avoid any trouble at the start.
Albon can certainly do the best he can do and then hope for the best. One thing for as Alex Dan moves into second. The only thing, he can do is now look at Danta second and Riccardo Becchelli, new entry, new face to the series in third for this final round. Conor Wagner is also on a very good lap for Delta Sport U4K as Holland puts his the sister car in pole position. Wagner is third. Where is Pagotto? Pagotto with a disappointing first lap. Alessandro, let's see if he can improve in the second lap.
As you can see on your button, at the bottom of your screen, he has been improving in the first part of the track, but not in the last sectors. He's now across the line and moves up to fifth, which is already good enough to put himself in a good starting spot, but not enough to be very safe at the start, because you know that anything can happen at Monza in turn one and also in the following chicane. You need to be very careful, especially in a one race championship like we have here on Apex Racing TV for this official series. So there's no room for any mistake.
Here comes Raul Eyman, the F3 Asia champion from a few years ago. I was actually watching some Euro Formula Open from the past and he was there, but he doesn't improve, unfortunately, only down to 16th. We have Karl Modoff, the American, also for Delta Sport U4K. He's having a pedestrian lap, unfortunately. He's all these drivers, of course, they will Certainly, Alessandro, they will want to get as far as possible because in qualifying, because once the race comes, it might be easy to stay in the draft, but I don't know. I mean, and you can also make the move. The problem is, of course, then pulling away from your opposition. And of course, as you were saying earlier, the more cars you have around you, as Modov, you know, shuts me up and puts his car into seventh with a good final part of the lap. As I was saying, the more cars, as we were saying, the more cars you have around you, you know, the bigger the risk, especially in the first and second chicane, as we are across the start-finish line, and we are ready to go with the grid.
Yes, qualifying is over. The grid is right here in front of you. David Holland is our pole sitter for Delta Sport U4K. Almost 2/10 on Luca Albon, followed by David Holland teammates Connor Wagner in third and Flavio Dantas in fourth. Fifth place for Gianfranco Pagotto, so good qualifying. Alongside him is Riccardo Becchelli, another Italian driver, new to the broadcast races here on Apex Racing TV. Karl Modorf, Alex Dunn, Francesco Meuda and Marco Zippoli round up the top 10. Plenty of Italians in the top 10 for the home race. Hugo Martinez and Adrian Falcon are in row 6, followed by Mark Ng, Jose Kaplan, Brian Collins, Raul Ayman, Ted Bradbury, Manu Reo Largo, Andrea Rosso, Bernie Perez, Paolo Draetta, Javier Duengo, Carlos De Recho e Zoltan Zomotto in 24th. Conor Bell is in 25th. Last place is the only driver that did not post a valid lap time in qualifying. So this race definitely, Marco, is gonna be very important for the top two drivers, but we need to keep in mind also all the other ones that are ready to spoil the party for Pagotto and Albon trying to get a win at the end of the season and end on a high, but mostly they are still fighting for their position in the championship, so there's still plenty of places to be made in the middle pack.
They have every right to fight for their position, and they have every right to ignore the fight for the title, you know, so this is I think this can get absolutely spicy, as the lights are on with a few seconds earlier than expected.
Yeah, engines are roaring and the drivers are ready to go racing here. Monza, great start for David Holland. Albon still side by side, but he won't be able to try a move on the inside. Drivers trying to make as wide as possible to avoid any pass. Looks
oh, we
everything
have a big wreck.
Pretty clear in the start of the field, as we have drivers sideways at the chicane. Draetta might have been losing a few places. We will absolutely have a replay of that. Ooh, someone is dragging a cone on these backstretches. Thankfully, the 22 car of Brink Collins manages to get it away. It's very, very difficult to drive with a cone stuck in your front wing, but a great start from our top drivers. Pagotto still in fourth, managed to get a position at the start.
Conor Wagner with a bad start, minus 5, as of course everyone goes wide. Oh, we have a massive hit for Collins.
Collins in the 22, day is pretty much over for him. Still some more cars trying to rejoin the tram. Manu Reo Largo, our number one in the room, dragging with only 3 wheels now, so his days will be also over. Look at this driver using also the gravel on the outside of at the exit of Ascari to get even more speed.
As they get into the draft, look at that, because Alex Dunn was having a big fight with Conor Wagner, moving left and right behind them, the two wave Italy cars of Zipoli and Meola, as Becchelli is trying to attack Pagotto as we complete our first lap out of 20. Becchelli, I'm seeing, if I can get him on board, yeah, also with wave DRS Italy, so... Oh, look at that, in the middle is Alex Tan! Oh, but he skips the chicane. He skips the chicane. This is certainly not what you know the title contenders want, but as I was saying, it seems to me like the Quave guys have really come out in big numbers as Albon is trying to make the pass for the lead.
Pagotto
jumps Dantas. Yeah.
Great pass from Pagotto, moving up another place. Third place will guarantee Pagotto the win of the championship. Ooh, the tank car going very wide on entry. Oh, Bekele's around.
Bekele, yeah. That one of the
too
first,
much master.
Yeah, the first ally of Pagotto is off. And he's dropping like a stone.
In 7-8 players trying to help him in the hunt for the championship, but so far Marco, he does not need any help because he's doing a great job, and now we only try to open up even a bigger gap as a Modov was a very very wide exit in Ascari.
Here we go, big draft of course with Dan trying to come back as Zipoli is as Meola is defending on the inside, that comes to the outside. Here comes the Frenchman Hugo Martinez as they go onto the start finish straight for another lap. Flying formation as Meola and Dan still side by side as they come into the first corner once again. Let's see if Dan can stop his car this time. He can, but he gets it.
Yeah, going side by side there is very very difficult. Meola will maintain 8th place, but Dan unfortunately two times in that first chicane had the trouble. Last lap he missed the chicane, and now I think he will have some damage on his car. We will see in the next corners, but if he doesn't have a lot of damage apart from some front wing damage, I would be really really surprised. David Holland, our leader.
Yeah, Holland, of course, still in the hunt for important race victory. Unfortunately for him, not in the hunt for the title anymore. If Albon finishes second, Pagotto must finish ninth or higher. So far, he is absolutely, as you were saying earlier, Alessandro, in that range, and absolutely in a good position. Let's say be the master of his own destiny.
Oh yeah, for sure. Pagotto has put himself in a very good position to control the situation and make sure that he will get what he needs to win the title, as we are looking at Pat Bradbury, Bernie Perez and Andrea Rosso fighting for 11th place. Bradbury will now have to fend from the upcoming Spaniard, can see actually here little the car bottoming out on the front straight from Bradbury. Let's see if he can outbreak Perez in turn one. Yes, he does. Nice apex and a great exit. He will now have also the slipstream from Alex Dan.
Raul Eiman suffering a bit today, down into 17th. He started 16th, so not the greatest of races for him, as Rosso also takes a swipe at Perez and gets the job done with I would say one of the best liveries we've seen all season.
Oh yeah, for sure. Everyone knows that magenta color is always our favorite, but that great characters Tom and Jerry definitely are even better than the color itself.
This is a win-win situation. I think one of the best liveries we've seen all season, as we have Javier Ruiz Arduengo going for a spin at Variante della Roggia. He's several laps down, unfortunately, already 3 laps down, as the leaders are about to start their 5th lap of the day. Holland, Albon, Pagotto. Let's see for Pagotto if Dantas is closing in on him. Maybe this lap would be more indicative.
Pagotto, Marco, as long as Albon is in second place, it's all fine. He only needs to worry, really, if Albon, sorry, will make the move for third place and get the win in the end, because if Albon finishes second, he will only need a ninth place, which is absolutely not an issue if he keeps the car out of trouble. But if Albon gets a win, he must finish fourth, and the gap between him and Modov is still 2 seconds, so it's not a very big gap. He needs to keep that in mind.
Back to this fight, as Alex Dan, clearly with some damage, I would imagine, as he gets attacked by Radtree as they enter the Lesmo 2 corner. Guys, don't go 3 wide. Thank you very much. Here comes Bradbury, a little bit of a tap maybe, and Dan once again finds himself through the daisies.
You can see the front wing damage on the left side of his car, completely bent, and this is definitely not what you need on a track like Monza, where you're already running at the lowest downforce possible, where you can have still some grip in these tight corners, and having that front damage is gonna send him quite backwards in these remaining 15 laps. He's already in 13th place, and there are still a few cars behind him looking to make a move.
Yeah.
We lost Ayman in the meantime, Marco. Yeah. He was struggling already, and he decided or made a mistake maybe, and is now out of the event.
Conor Wagner, fastest lap of the race, is putting some pressure on his teammate Karl Modov. Basically, going back to the problem for Alex Dan, that he and as Carlos De Recio goes past him, I know it's not the longest of races, this one, Alessandro, but maybe Alex should go and, you know, take a gamble and change that front wing, because he's basically running with a parachute attached to your car.
Oh yeah, for sure, but if you do it, you need to do it as soon as you get damage. Now it's pretty much all time loss from lap 3 to lap 6, so he already committed to staying out at this rate. It's better if he stays out, otherwise he will lose even more time by pitting. So I think it's better now to keep on going and see what he can do, but obviously we'll be a sitting duck for the next 15 laps, because the guys behind him, I have all a clear car and I have no damage, will be for sure able to pass him fairly easily, even though we know Alex Dan has a lot of speed, but with damage there's not much he can do.
But on the other hand, maybe pitting even now, he's going to lose 2 positions. He will come out in front of Marcus G, I would imagine, and at least you know, these final few laps will be basically hot lapping, but at least he will not have to fight and drop backwards, you know. As Modov answers straight back to his teammate Wagner and takes himself the fastest lap of the race. Here we go on the start finish straight. Dan, I think, has no intent on pitting, and unfortunately he is going to be overtaken by Conor Bell, makes the stick, and now Rosso on the outside of Bradbury. Alessandro, Bradbury keeps the position defending on the inside, and so these 3 guys here, Bradbury, Rosso and Perez, stay exactly where they were. Let's also keep an eye on Riccardo Pechelli, because he is coming back after his big mistake earlier in the race, and you can see the time, you know, the clock is certainly not kind on poor Alex Dan and his damage.
Absolutely, indeed.
The stopwatch, it's the stopwatch, not the clock.
He will struggle to maintain this 15th place. Marco, we have already been here last week, I think, if I'm correct, with the Formula Renault 3.5 broadcast, and we were talking about being careful in these corners, because if you try to make a pass when you are fighting with multiple drivers for position and you don't make the pass work, it's very easy that you might even lose that spot to the guy behind. So Rosso in this case, he needs to be very careful to when attack Bradbury has, he makes a move stick here, a parabolica, but now he runs wide and Bradbury will still have the inside, but Luca Perez, because he will have a double toe now, even though he elects to go all the way on the outside of the track and not even get some slipstream.
Strange.
Now, yeah, definitely. I was expecting
Barbanera tactic, you know? Barbanera level IQ tactic.
Ooh, Bradbury very wide. Yeah, makes the car wide on exit and keeps that position. Now he has to go around the outside, the long way around, giving Andrea Rosso the chance to move back into 10th place. But Bernie Perez might be just taking it easy to avoid getting tangled in if anything happens between these two guys, Marco.
Meantime, while we were watching, and I am very scared to move away, but I have to, because Karl Modov has jumped into fourth. He has gone past Flavio Tantas. Let's see how this happened.
And Modov definitely looking very, very strong so far. Easy move down the inside. Looks easy, it's definitely not easy for sure. But Modov making up another place as Rosso gets the big curb on the entrance of Ascari. Now we'll have to defend on Ted Bradbury again. Inverted the place is compared to the last lap, but look who is coming behind him. It's Carlos Derecho. So we have a four-way battle now for the last spot in the top 10, with Bradbury trying to go all the way around the Italian driver. And now getting a very good exit, but they need to be both careful, because the drivers behind them for sure will not give up and try to make two spots in one try.
Here we go, almost three wide. Derecho lifts smartly, so does Perez, but now Perez attacks and also on the inside. Oh, careful jumping on the curb. And now we have Connor Bell also. Wow, I mean, if they keep on not passing each other and staying line astern, we might have the entire second half of the grid joining this party very, very soon, Alessandro. By the way...
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Oh! Bradbury wants to pass! Oh, careful! Oh, Rosso goes wide! Perez goes in the grass! It's all happening! Beautiful way to end the season!
Absolutely great race between these guys. Now also Bekele, after passing Dan, joins the party. So we have now six drivers within 2 seconds. So if someone makes some mistakes trying to pass someone else, they might even drop to the tail end of this group, from a possible 10th place to 15th. Alex Dan is not far away, but still with damage is gonna have a hard time then to be competitive in this group, as you see him go very, very wide on the gravel and almost losing control. He's definitely not happy, but he's giving everything he's got to keep up with these guys.
You know, if there is a crash, Carlos Derecho will never be in the wrong.
Yeah, because he's always right.
Exactly. I see you are a man of culture, Alessandro.
Absolutely. I agree on that. As we have...
promptly goes three wide.
Just... Oh, yeah. You never leave. You never back off. You always go for it. As Bernie Perez now, after taking a few laps to get the handle of these guys in front of him, makes a pass and moves into 10th place. Let's see if now the pace of this group will ramp up a little bit and we will see some shifting between these drivers. Also, Andrea Rosso tries to make a move on Derecho and makes his stick, so the 18 car now moves up into 12th position. Great battle between the midfielder. We always said, Marco, in this broadcast that yeah, it's very important to keep an eye on the front, but usually the most intense racing happens always in the midfield.
It does, and I love that, of course, this being the last round of the season. Wait, you know, we cannot finish our sentences every time, because I every time we start saying something, we have an overtake attempt. This case is Bekele getting on the retro. There is our good friend Sam Fitzpatrick in the chat. And of course, he will be a very, 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 very special guest later today in the season finale of the Formula 3.5 Championship, where we'll be giving out the title as well. Thankfully, Sam doesn't speak Spanish, because if he had understood our pun, he would have gone on a strike, probably.
Yeah, probably the only one understanding that great pun are us both. But Bernie Perez is definitely not giving up, trying to defend that 10th place in that beautiful McLaren colors. We're starting to see less McLaren, at least of this color, on the track after Alonso moved to Alpine. So we might see some different liveries coming up in the next season. But Marco, we should also keep an eye on the leaders. Oh, Bradbury goes. Oh!
Che pigna! Che pigna, Alejandro!
Oh, yes, definitely. It was definitely a very big pigna between Bradbury and Rosso. Let's see the replay. Ted Bradbury. Too much master on entrance. Banana curves definitely not helped there, and Rosso has no way to avoid him. So, unfortunate race ending for Ted Bradbury and Andrea Rosso. Best livery on track today, for sure.
Oh, nothing he could have done on that. And also, I think Paulo Draeta and Alex Dunn have got... see, Paulo Draeta might have just skipped the first chicane.
Saved it, but definitely a very big moment for the Brazilian driver. Alex Tan probably just went off track avoiding the car of Andrea Rosso. Alex Tan now makes up a few positions, two freebies to make up some position lost after the damage. So he's now in 14th place, but in no man's land, as Wagner makes a pass on Flavio Dantas. So after losing a position to another Delta U4K driver, Dantas slides backwards in 6th place.
This
but Pagotto, Marco, Inter.
New iRacing off-track, Alessandro, sorry if I interrupt, but iRacing put off-tracks in between Lesmo 1 and Lesmo 2. So every time I see the name of the leaders flashing red, I imagine a big wreck for one of the championship contenders, and in reality they just gone slightly wide. I think it was changed 2 builds ago. By the way, the new release notes are out already. The draft of the release notes is out. There could still be some changes. Of course, go read them at the end of this race.
Oh yeah, for sure. We have definitely no time to go through release notes now, because we are about to start lap 13, and Albon is still 1.5 behind David Holland, so this will definitely make our third place man Gianfranco Pagotto very happy. His third place finish would anyway be enough, even if Albon gets the win, as Bekele, after a big mistake at the start, made up 6 position in the span of 4 or 5 laps, and now manages to enter back into the top 10, making a pass on Bernie Perez. And here instead we look at Flavio Dantas from this great camera on Conor Wagner front rear wing. You see all these drivers, Marco, dropping a wheel on the grass on entry in a lot of cars, I must say. I always get scared, because whenever I try to do that, as also I tried this morning in the VRS endurance race I did with other commentators here on Racing TV, didn't work for me, so either I am the one I do not have the skills, which is probably the reason why, or these guys have a trick I don't know.
If they have a trick, they please can tell me, you know.
Oh yeah, for sure. We definitely are in much needed help to boost our on-track performances lately.
I mean, no, because if you really, you know, go down and put your heart into it, you know, you are a 5,000, 6,000 rating guy, whilst I am hopeless, you know, so...
But we have won a save in 12 hours, so that will always remain in our great palmarès. As we look at the gap comparison between the drivers, and now we check on another great battle between Dantas and Wagner for fifth place, with Flavio Dantas getting the pass done and moving back into the top five on lap 14. These Delta 4 U4K drivers are always very competitive. Have you seen multiple battles between Wagner, Dantas, and all these competitors in throughout all the season? Great races, sometimes very interesting wrecks, I must add, Marco. We had some tremendous wrecks throughout the last events. These cars always provide great fun.
I have to say, tonight the drivers have behaved massively, especially in the first laps. Really, there was nothing out of the ordinary for BM Monza. Skander Wagner once again gets the draft of Flavio Dantas, but doesn't force the issue. He knows that the smart place to make the move is in fact turn one, and he keeps his Dallara F317 straight behind Dantas, then pulls out of said draft and moves on the outside, and back moves on the inside, of course, back in front of the Brazilian, makes the move stick. But for how long, we wonder, as we are entering the final six laps of this race. The race has calmed down a bit. This is the only fight we have on the track. The other closest fight is Pagotto, with just 1 second in front of Modov. And actually, let's see the gap between the pair of them. It is slightly in favor of Modov, apart from the last lap, where Pagotto gained almost 0.2 seconds on him. So far, so good for Pagotto. And of course, for Pagotto, the biggest relief is right in front of him, seeing Albon unable to catch up Holland, and in that case, of course, Wagner will be the car to watch, the fifth place car, the one to watch for Gianfranco Pagotto. Let me also say a big thanks to Sam Fitzpatrick, who kept track of the points all season long and is giving us these championship permutations, and it makes a rarity, by the way, on iRacing in general, to be able to announce the winner straight away after the end of a race, which we will be able to do more often the next few weeks with the new systems we have for the Apex Racing leagues. Speaking of which, Alessandro, we have this very calm moment, so why don't we give some shoutouts to our sponsor? I will start with the one I know the most. And of course, is SDK Gaming, which provides you with all these beautiful highlights, these beautiful graphics on your screen, overlays, and it can be useful both for broadcasting, but also for your own online single experience. It can give you all the data you want, live timing, pit strategy. You know, anything you can want and more. And of course, once you get a license for SDK Gaming, you can of course use it for your own broadcasts as well. Basically, you can do whatever you want with it. sdk-gaming.co.uk for more. Tell them that Marco sent you and you will still pay full price. And of course, Alessandro, you are more of a driver than me, so I know you know our other two sponsors much better than me.
Absolutely, and I want just to remind our Italian friends that I know always are keen for F3 Racing that we also have SDK Gaming in Italian. So,
yes,
if you want, you can ask Marco, he's the one in charge of all translations and help for the Italian community.
I did only the Italian. I wish I had done every translation. No, I've only done one, the Italian one, but yes.
And also our other proud sponsors, I must obviously thank Apex Racing Academy for being the sponsor of this great championship with their 29 data packs, setups, track guides, weekly group coaching session, one-on-one coaching sessions also just announced a few weeks ago, as we have a move for third place. Car Modo looking at the inside of Pagotto, Pagotto just letting him go to the inside and now trying to come back with a good exit after the second chicane, looks at the inside, Modo keeps the car very very stable on the outside, which is very very difficult to do, and maintains this third place. So great move by Car Modo. Now Pagotto will just have to stick behind his draft and make sure he will not lose any other positions. But remember, guys, that the Apex Racing Academy is also integrated with the V2N Racing School. So you have everything on just one website, all kind of setups and track guides you might need for your racing career. And also, just one quick shout out to the fact that you can still, even if quite late, run 10 races in the official iRacing series and with our Apex Racing Academy logo, and be eligible for a nice contest at the end of the season. So if you haven't done yet, make sure to do it to be eligible for that.
Man, I put that sponsor on every car I have, so if I don't win, I will be very, very salty. By the way, Pagotto doesn't seem to be content with finishing fourth. He wants he really didn't like being overtaken by Modov. Hopefully this won't come back to bite him, you know, because he seems to be very, very willing to get that position back on Modov. Modov, by the way, plus four. Great race from the American. It makes two Delta Sport U4K cars in the top three, and of course three in the top five, with Conor Wagner also having a fantastic comeback in fifth place. The top 10.
Look
is,
how wide Pagotto went there.
Top 10 is rounded up by Dantas, Zipoli, Meola, Martinez, and the resurgent Bekelli. As we move the cameras back to our leader, we have neglected a bit between the midfield fight and the title fight, but I mean, he has been absolutely lights out today, you know. And I have to say, Holland had a fantastic championship, finishing in the top three in the final standings in this beautiful and strong field is absolutely no easy task, and he is one step closer to bring home a prestigious victory in the final race of the season here at the Temple of Speed at Monza. Two laps to go, 43.3, 43.2 for Albon, 42.8 for Modov. And here comes Pagotto once again in the draft. There is a lapped car in the mid, on the side.
And there was Tanto Motor in 17th place.
I want to make an... if you're a fan of Formula E, you will know our pain in this moment. An appeal for next season, because all of our major players, apart from the Dantas brothers, have a dark black, have a black livery on their car, black or dark blue. Delta Sport U4K, Wave Italy, the fantasy livery of Luca Albon. So please, someone get some color for next season on their car.
Yeah, bring some magenta on your cars, and Marco and I will be super happy. We'll definitely cheer for you on track.
Yeah, poor Andrea Russo. I will have to contact him because that was, you know, a one-off livery, but a delivery of the season nonetheless. Draft fest once again on the inside is Pagotto, trying to get everything he can from Modov. At some point you must think, Alessandro, how worthy is it taking the risk, you know?
Well, the gap between him and the ninth place is quite big, but I don't think it's worth it to risk any big move right now, as the white flag is waved by our great marshals here in Monza. Final white flag of the season here on Apex Racing TV for the Apex Academy F3 Championship, as Pagotto looks at the inside of car Modov. Modov giving him plenty of space. Pagotto risking a little bit both sideways, but Pagotto has a better exit and will now move up in third place. But it's not done yet, because Modov will have a little bit of slipstream now here on the second part of the stretch, and he will be now looking to outbreak the Italian driver having the inside the favorite line. Yes, Pagotto does not even try to maintain the position, just slides back in fourth and make sure to not get tangled in any incident, which is the only thing that matters to him in this final lap.
And I think that this was the last firework for today's race. For Pagotto, you will have to be happy with P4. Nothing to, you know, no shame for Albon, and because Albon did everything he could, but Holland was too good today. And here we go, final corner.
David Holland with another great race. We've seen him being very, very fast all season long. Unfortunately, he fell short a bit in a few races, some unfortunate events. Did not give him the chance to win the title, at least contend for it. But Avidon is our race winner in round number 12 of the Apex Racing Academy F3 Championship. And Gianfranco Pagotto is our championship winner for DRS Wave Italy. The Italian celebrating at home soil the title for season 1 2021 here on iRacing, as we look at Carlos De Recio in 12th place. Toes down on Bernie Perez, but it's quite late and there's no way he can make up another position. But a great race, great driving from everyone. Obviously, Marco, we had a few retirements. Monza is well known for causing a lot of havoc at the start, but this driver kept fairly clean. A few mistakes is normal, unfortunately, in this track, to make mistake. And when you are always so packed at the start, it's inevitable to have a few cars out.
Yeah, a lot of drivers. We've had six retirements. Here come Draeta and Kaplan. They are actually one lap apart. There's Zoltan's motor in between them. He's already home. And last but not least of our finishing drivers, number one in the room, Manuel Rey Olargui, will get almost 100 day rating hit. Unfortunately for him, but yeah. Nothing that can't be recovered, especially if you are such a quick driver like him. Alessandro, let's go with the official results. We can say official because it's an iRacing official series, right? Here we go.
Absolutely, there's no way this result can be changed. David Holland in our race winner for Delta Sport U4K. 1.7 of a second is the gap between him and Luca Albon. Second place today at Monza, second place in the championship. Third place for Carl Modov, ending the season with a double podium finish for Delta Sport U4K. Gianfranco Pagotto in fourth is our title winner for DRS Wave Italy. Fifth place for Conor Wagner, sixth for Fabio Danta, seventh place for Marco Zippoli, eighth for Francesco Meola, teammate, of our title winner, Hugo Martinez in 9, 10th Ricardo Becchelli, Bernie Perez, Carlos Derecho, Connor Bell, Alex Dunn in 14th place with a lot of damage. Unfortunately, he kept on going, but that damage didn't give him the chance to contend for higher positions. Marco Insuengi and Jose Kaplan round up our field that finished on the same lap of our leaders. Zoltan Zomotor and Paolo Dreita one lap down. Manu Reio Largo in 19th. Andrea Rosso is our first retiree for today, with Ted Bradbury, Raul Ayman, Brian Collins, Javier Aduengo and Adrian Falcon out of the race earlier on in 25th place.
Of course, we must not forget the official iRacing Championship, of course, which was running in parallel with the little championship we had here on Apex Racing, Apex Racing TV. We don't know the results of that as of yet, but certainly for our...
I'm looking at the stream chat, and apparently David Holland is the winner, the champion of the official series. So if it's that so, we will ask him in a few seconds, as he's ready for our interview. So we will bring him up and ask him directly.
That's
the best way. Yeah, David, how are you doing? Great race, great win, and I think you also won the official championship today.
Yeah, hey guys. I think that'll pretty much seal the deal. It feels really good. The whole team worked really hard this week to put a setup together, but you know, most importantly, I got to thank Connor Wagner on the team. He is a setup guru, looks at all the data, and really got us something that worked well today. So a huge shout out to him.
We're focusing mostly on our broadcast championship, but for sure for you and especially the whole team, winning the title in this opening season of 2021 must feel great. And also your teammate did a great job today. Three cars in the top five, two cars in the top three. Amazing, a great team effort today.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks. I really appreciate it. You know, the whole team really did good. And like I said, we worked extra hard on the setup this week. And man, as you can tell, it really came together. Lots of pressure, though, because, like you said, the official championship, basically whoever won today, or whoever between me and Pagato, I think, whoever beat each other there, I think, was going to take it. So still lots of pressure, and glad to get it done.
Any plans for the upcoming season? Will you still be contending in this championship, or you and your teammates maybe will move to another series coming up, maybe to the IR01 for the World Championships?
We're still not sure. We're kind of kicking it around. I've tried so many cars on the service, and I just keep coming back to the F3. I think it's such a great car to drive, and a fantastic car to race as well. You know, some of the closest, hardest racing I've had in my racing has been with the F3. So I imagine I'll probably still be dabbling in the F3 next season, if not running it as my main series again.
Well, thank you very much, David. Before we let you go, anyone you would like to thank?
Yeah, definitely. Got to thank you guys for the awesome broadcast in Apex Racing Academy for putting the broadcast on. It's been a real joy this season having these really high strength of field races and having the broadcast. So really appreciate that. Maybe it'll come back next season. We'll see. And then also, of course, got to thank the team Delta Sport and all the team sponsors. Move Up Transportation Solutions, 3M USA, Race Factory, Unify for Kids, Get Stuck. And once again, huge thanks to Connor for the setup this week. Thanks, guys.
Congratulations, Dave, for the win and the title in the official championship. Now, Marco, we can move to Karl Modov, teammate of David, who finished in third place. Karl, how are you doing? Must feeling really, really good for your teammate, but also on your side, this race was definitely a very good performance.
Yeah, congrats to David on the world champion for the F3. That's awesome. you know, it's hard to do come week after week throughout this whole thing and be fast every week. So congrats to him. He killed it this season. And then, yeah, it's tough for me. I had a great race. That was a lot of fun. I just botched my qualifying. You know, I think I had the pace to qualify near, maybe between David and Luca. I don't think I could have done a six like David did, but, you know, I could have been at least up there, and I think it could have been a different race where we maybe could have had at least a little closer battle with David and Luca if I started up front. But considering where I started, had a couple crazy opening laps, almost had contact with a few guys there. Opening laps in the F3 car at Monza, usually a lot of people like to go send on the brakes. So avoided some crashes, got by, made some spots up, and then just kind of get your head down, try and see if you can catch them. It's kind of tough. I thought the draft would have a bigger effect, and I thought the dirty air would have less of effect. But once I caught Gianfranco, it was like a second behind him. I just kind of got stuck there. And then finally at the end, he made a couple little mistakes, so I was able to get close enough to get a run on him. And after following him for all those laps, realizing how hard it is to even get close enough, I just wanted to pass him and try and stay ahead of him. I wasn't going to try and plan out, you know, hey, I'm going to pass him into the parabolica or anything. I just decided the best was track position, try to get ahead and stay ahead. And luckily that was able to happen to round out the podium.
Absolutely a great race from you, especially starting the middle of the pack in the opening laps is always very tricky, and we've just seen this great replay from Marco on of lap three, I think, when Alex Dan tried to make it three wide at turn one. It was definitely a very hectic moment, but you made it and got a great podium for the team. Anyone you would like to thank, Carl?
First, thank Connor Wagner. He made our setup this week super fast. We've been flying all week, so big thanks to him for that knowledge and effort he put into building that setup. And then just thanks to the team, Delta Sport, U4K, Move Up Transportation, Freem USA. And then also thanks to you guys, the announcers and race organizers. Thanks, guys. Maybe we'll see you next season.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Carl. I appreciate it.
Cheers, guys.
Well, Marco, it was a very, very quick season, I must say. We are already round 12 over, and the season pretty much decided, both for official and for sure for our own broadcast championship.
Yeah, I was a bit confused, but then after, you know, after refreshing the website 100 times, it has updated, because it seemed like Pagotto had an you know, unsurmountable lead, but you never know with these drop weeks. You really need to, you know, really be making some very, you know, deep calculations to know, but now after having refreshed everything, seems like David Holland with 1845 points, Luke Albon seven, and Albon is in second, and Pagotto is in third, but Pagotto has 9 weeks counted for some reason, you know, but I trust the guys that you know, Delta Sport U4K have done their calculations, and especially because I am very, very, you know, not reliable even when making simple additions. So, congratulations to David for his official title. Congratulations to Gianfranco for his Apex Racing Academy title. We have, of course, more stuff on the line for you guys today and tomorrow. Of course, later today, in around 2 hours' time, a bit less than that, to be precise, we will give out the official championship title for the iRacing Formula 3.5 Championship. Final race of the season from, of course, a place that is no stranger for title deciders. That's going to be, of course, Autodromo José Carlos Pace. The title fight between Edward Zamborski and James J. Pinsker. And of course tomorrow we also have the final round of the Spec Racer Ford Weekend Warriors. That's very tight as well, and the final round of the IGP Fan Series as well. So if you want to stick with us in 1 hour and a half time, it's going to be me, Alessandro, and more importantly special guest Sam Fitzpatrick. You will see another title being decided. It's always, always exciting when we can finally say an idea. I haven't said it today, but we can say we can crown le champion. So make sure you say it later, Alessandro, because I will be doing cameras. But thanks a lot to everyone. Alessandro, closing thoughts, all yours.
Thank you very much, Mark, for this beautiful rundown here on Apex Racing TV from beautiful Autodromo Nazionale di Monza. Is day over. Thanks for watching this great season finale of the Apex Racing Academy F3 Championship from Alessandro Dalidon and Marco Barbanera. We wish you a good night.